Annexstad, the true freshman, has the arm. But on the first play, he's going to defer to the ground game. And Muhammad Ibrahim. Ibrahim returned last week after missing a pair with a left leg injury.
Like to play coverage, and they like to put pressure with only four guys. But here comes the blitz.
And the blitz is coming from both sides, and Annexstad has taken down Anthony Nelson with his third sack of the season. And ready to go after that loss at home to Wisconsin 2 weeks ago. An early look at the right arm of Nate Stanley, and wide open Nick Easley. Pitch and catch all the way to the 40-yard line for a gain of 13. Lee Martin, the sophomore in the backfield, standing to the left of Stanley. And complete, another really easy pitch and catch, this time to Brandon Smith. It'll be third and short. Stanley rolling, throwing, completing, first down Iowa. Amir Smith-Marset, the sophomore, with his first catch of the game, and it's a big one. Third down and seven. Pressure coming. Completion to Kelly Martin out of the backfield. Down to the 5-yard line. Number 21's been the go-to guy. Over the middle. Caught. And guess what? It's a tight end. TJ Hawkinson. His first touchdown catch of the season. This time it's Mekhi Sargent in the backfield with Stanley. Pressure up the middle. Stanley. Oh, he's got him wide open. Smith-Marset down the sideline and into the end zone. Touchdown, Iowa. Stanley avoids the pressure and hooks up with Smith-Marset for a 60-yard score. He only had 12 yards against Maryland, but that's because he was double-teamed a lot, Tyler Johnson, as they go to Ibrahim. That's really changed things for their defense at safety without him on the field. Annexstad. And that is caught by Chris Hartman Bell. He's able to pull it in. It'll be first and goal, Minnesota. Annexstad, short drop. Puts it in the air, and it is caught for the touchdown by the freshman, Rashad Bateman. Kirk Ferentz, you asked him, what's your biggest concern? He said those wideouts in Minnesota, they could hurt you.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with him.
And look at Amir Smith-Marset out to the 35. So continue to keep an eye on those cornerbacks for Iowa. Over the middle, and it's caught. Chris Hartman Bell with another catch. Well, Iowa got up 14-0, and it just felt like there was no energy in TCF Bank Stadium. But that has really shifted, and just as I say that, a sack of Annexstad. Off of play action. And guess what? Who's there? 98, Anthony Nelson. First three drives for Iowa, they just had 9 rushing yards. In the last two plays, they've had 14. Stanley running out and throwing for the first down into the hands of Brandon Smith. First catch for the Mississippi native. And Stanley able to complete it down to Brandon Smith. First and goal, Hawkeyes. And they still have Stanley out there. Or no, that's Rastetter, the punter. But they snap it to the right, and it's Hawkinson. And T.J. Hawkinson is in for the Hawkeyes. Kirk Ferentz pulls a rabbit out of his hat. Looking pretty good throwing the ball. He'll be hobbled running it with that left ankle injury. That ball batted in the air. It's caught. Off the deflection. Bateman still able to hold it in. Maybe not how they drew it up.
If any.
They know he's got the leg. Oh, how about that? A little wind in the Twin Cities to aid the redshirt senior Emmett Carpenter. Here comes the pressure, and they dump it off left side. Wide open, Kelly Martin. First down, and then some. But he struggled to get it going on the ground, as is the entire Iowa contingent in the backfield. Over the middle, caught, touchdown, Nick Easley. Stanley with his third touchdown pass of the half, and his parents in the crowd, Jay and Donita, they love it as well. Watch the play clock here. And it's dead, hit and drop. Chauncey Golston.
There they go.
They're throwing. And completed. A lot of room to run. And all the way inside the 30.
You can see why they want to throw it. There's a mismatch there.
Double team most of that game. Maybe that's the catch he needs to break out. And this time for the end zone, and it is intercepted by the freshman Riley Moss. Well, they have picked on him time and time again, and this time he says, no, sir. And then a teaching moment on the sideline, Fleck and Annexstad. Iowa with two timeouts and a minute. Some change, and there's an interception. Jacob Huff with a pick. Wow. Momentum shifts. And Annexstad will come right back onto the field. Minnesota can get the ball in the end zone here in the PAT. All of a sudden, you've got some momentum going into the locker room, and they get it into the end zone right there. Tyler Johnson, touchdown. Stanley on an island by himself.
The blitz coming with the blitz.
Blitz up the middle, throw down the sideline. Did he catch that? There's a flag as well, but Brandon Smith caught it.
This is not going to work because they're playing man coverage. That's the best route to go to. So, yes.
40-yard field goal. This time, no fake. They kick it, and it is up and good for Miguel Racinos. Still has been a game of passing between the two teams. 81 rushing yards combined. Pressure from the backside. Stanley lost it. It is picked up and taken inside the five by Thomas Barber.
And if I had to bet, it was Carter Coughlin off the backside.
It was indeed.
Recovered by Minnesota.
He'll go again. And Seth Green scores it for the Gophers. And we've got a one-score football game. As Iowa's lead has dwindled down to 7. Smith-Marset with a return. Stays on his feet. And finally gets upended by Jacob Huff, the last line of defense. Watching his offense go on and operate with Nate Stanley under center. And the give to Kelly Martin. Martin with a hole. Lowering his shoulder. First down gain as he pushes over Antonio Shadault. Stanley on 3rd and 8. He's got the first down. Right around the 20. Hawkinson, who has 2 touchdowns today, able to hold on for 16 yards. Yeah, Noah Fant is on the right side of that line. He's looking that way, and Noah Fant has it for the Iowa touchdown. The tight end show continues for the Hawkeyes. Points, it's been a good game for you, and still 14:39 remaining. So Seth Green, the guy, and he's going to throw it. He's going to throw it deep. And he's going to have it intercepted by Julius Brents. How about the true freshman quarterbacks for Iowa? So Iowa, no points off their 2 turnovers. Minnesota, they have taken advantage of the Iowa turnovers and cashed those in for 2 touchdowns. Annexstad, though, nowhere to go, and eventually he's dropped back around the 10-yard line.
You got to get rid of that ball. Right?
But Maryland sacked Annexstad 4 times, and that was too far, and it's intercepted. It's Riley Moss again. His 2nd pick of the game. Welcome to college football, Riley Moss. There's no spur of the moment logic erased by emotion.
Well, I can tell Brian there's only one guy that made that decision. It's Dad, Kurt Ferentz. Period.
He stayed true to his word to be a Gopher. Up the middle, pretty good hole across the 40. In this game, 11 carries, 47 yards for him. But Annexstad throwing this time and completing it. Right back to Rashad Bateman. Annexstad keeps looking for Bateman. He got it. Somehow he fit that between three defenders. And Bateman has his second touchdown.
Long field goal, go for it on fourth.
From here, it would be about a 48-yarder. Once again, the rollout, then Stanley Thompson goes the other way, and wide open is T.J. Hockenson. And he is going to be pushed out just short. Almost his third touchdown of the game.
Be impressed with this run defense of the Gophers.
So much better than they were 2 weeks ago. Did he get in there? Yes. This time, however, Iowa pushes through with a rushing touchdown. Mekhi Sargent with his fourth of the season, first of the day. Well, you hoisted Floyd 4 years during your tenure at Minnesota, right through the middle.
Yeah, I think that's right.
We're going to be short-staffed at linebacker. And we resume play as Annexstad swings it downfield. It is intercepted again. Geno Stone, first career pick for the sophomore from Newcastle, Pennsylvania.
Their running game left a lot to be desired. Let's face it, I think Kirk Ferentz, Brian Ferentz would be the first ones to tell you that.
Yeah, 2.7 yards per rush, but all in all, off the bye week, you're 4-1, and Iowa's schedule going forward, pretty favorable.